Ventura. It's Ashley with your crime and safety update from the Ventura Police Department. Over the past month, we have received hundreds of handwritten notes from local students. We have read each and every note and appreciate the thoughtfulness of the community we serve. Thank you for supporting our Ventura police officers and support staff. I have two very special guests who are here today to share their letters. They both attend Ventura Missionary School, and during the Thomas Fire, their school gym was impacted. Firefighters were able to save the gym and protect the school.
My name is Evan. Thank you for saving our houses in Ventura. Thank you for saving our school. Thank you for saving our lives. Thank you for saving our community.
My name is Diego. Dear officer, thank you, officers, for helping our community and arresting the bad guys. Next. I love how you are protecting people's homes and giving us warnings. Third, I want to thank you for being so generous and nice to us. Fourth, I also want to thank you for helping the firefighters. Fifth, I like how you never, ever back down to a case and that you always figure it out. Last, I like police.
Recently, students from El Camino High School interviewed Police Chief Corney and Fire Chief Andaya about the Thomas Fire. Here's a segment from the interview.
What was the hardest part about getting people to evacuate? Did people not believe that it was happening at first, or were some people difficult and reluctant to leave their homes?
Well, I think the most challenging part was people wanting to stay behind to try and save their homes. And we really had what I would call a firestorm, you know, a blowtorch of fire coming into our city, into these neighborhoods. And we had very little time to evacuate, you know, over 27,000 people in those neighborhoods. And I think it was a success, and we met little resistance because of a few key issues. First of all, the police officers and the first responders in the neighborhoods with sirens and letting people know, you know, to evacuate and the fire was coming. Certainly, there was some awareness in the community. They saw the fire, the smoke, and things like that. Secondly, is our county participates together in what we call VC Alert, which is essentially a notification program that notifies people in the event of emergency that you have to register for.
In terms of intensity and spread, where does this fire rank in California history?
Well, as far as intensity in California history, it did reach the number one spot as far as acreage. It was the largest fire in recorded California history, but not the most destructive. So that's actually a good thing. That while it took a lot of acreage, it wasn't as destructive as other fires that even burned fewer acres. So we did lose a lot of homes here, directly in the city of Ventura, as well as in the unincorporated county areas. Career-wise, I've been in the fire service since about 1995, and I have never seen a fire like this locally or to any of the fires I've gone to. And I've gone all over the western United States, mostly obviously in California, and seeing devastating wildfires. But as far as the intensity and how quickly this fire made it from the east end of Santa Paula to the east end of Ventura the night of December 4th was unprecedented.
Ventura Police Chief Ken Corney and Fire Chief David Andaya presented to our Ventura City Council this week, urging our community to plan ahead and be prepared for natural disasters and the possibility of storms in the new year. It's important to take action by signing up to receive VC Alert mobile messages by contacting the VC Alert hotline at 648-9283 or by visiting vcalert.org. Subscribers will receive emergency notifications such as evacuation notices specific to their neighborhood. To learn more about how to prepare for an emergency, please visit readyventuracounty.org. Now let's take a look at our property crime stats for the past week.
Hello, I'm Officer Dillard, and I have been a Ventura police officer for 2.5 years. I love my job and love serving the city of Ventura. We are hiring, and I encourage you to apply. In the past 7 days in the city of Ventura, there were 3 residential burglaries, 4 vehicle burglaries, 14 thefts from unlocked vehicles, 6 stolen vehicles, 4 package thefts, and 2 mail thefts. Community members are encouraged to remove valuables and lock up. Oftentimes, criminals canvass neighborhoods in the middle of the night or early morning hours, checking door handles until they find an unlocked vehicle. Please help prevent this crime by locking up anytime you are away from your vehicle. Residential burglaries can also be prevented by securing all windows and doors before you leave your home. If you are away in the evening hours, a sensor light can help deter crime. Getting to know your neighbors and watching out for one another by reporting anything suspicious can also help deter this type of activity. Thank you and have a safe week.
Each week we provide these stats on property crime in Ventura. The crimes include residential burglaries, stolen vehicles, vehicle burglaries, which means entry is forced into a vehicle, often by window smash, vehicle thefts, which means a vehicle has been left unlocked and a suspect enters the unlocked vehicle to steal items. When there are thefts of packages or mail, we also include that information in our update. We provide this information to you so that you are aware of the property crime that is happening in our community, and so that you can be proactive in preventing this type of crime by securing your property. Locking those doors and removing anything of value from your vehicles is a big deterrent in preventing property crime. To see more details about other crime in our community, please visit our website to view our interactive crime map. You can select to view activity in a specific area or throughout our community for any period of time over the past 180 days. When you visit our website at venturapd.org, on the first page there is a circle that says Interactive Crime Map. Click on that icon and you will be provided with more information. Thank you for your time. If you have questions, please give us a call at 805-339-4317. We wish you a safe week. Remember to lock up. See you next time.